Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to set up subaccounts in strategic modeling. In the account view, you can view and manage the accounts and subaccounts in a model. Include subaccounts to provide additional detail within standard financial accounts. For example, within total SG&A expense, you can include subaccounts for salary expense, selling expense, and administrative expenses. That way, you can keep track of and report on these distinct components. Each subaccount is displayed in the account view and in respective financial statements. Subaccount IDs are displayed after the main account number, separated by a colon. A main account number drives the accounting integrity of the model. If there is a related account, it is the two-digit number after the first decimal place. The subaccount ID is at the end after a colon. Let's take a look at a subaccount. The salary expense account is a subaccount of SG&A. Its account number includes the main account, 1080, and the subaccount 10. If we review the subaccount information, we see the subaccount is displayed in the account ID, and the name of the account is displayed in account name. Type is set to add. Values for salary expense are additive and increase the SG&A value. For subaccounts, you can select Subtract to subtract a value from its parent, or you can select Ignore if the subaccount is independent of its parent. I'll add a subaccount to Administrative Expenses. You can add subaccount members to the account hierarchy by adding a child or a sibling member to the selected account. When you add subaccounts to income statement accounts, you produce one subaccount. You can edit subaccount information. I'll adjust the information for our new subaccount. In this case, I will track expense data for utilities separately. However, it will roll up into administrative expenses. I will add another subaccount. We want to also track expense data for rent separately. I'll enter data for rent and utilities, which are subaccounts of administrative expenses. We can see the subaccount data roll up to administrative expenses, and data for administrative expenses rolls up to the main account total SG&A. Let's take a look at administrative expenses on the income statement. I'll drill down on the value for administrative expenses to see the subaccount data. Let's take a look at an example of subaccounting on the balance sheet. Total inventories include three subaccounts: raw materials, work in progress, and finished goods. The raw materials account has an account number that includes the main account, 2040, and the subaccount, 10. I'll add a subaccount to a balance sheet account. When you subaccount a financial account that has related accounts, all of the related accounts are subaccounted automatically. I'll adjust the information for my new subaccount to better reflect what the data for this account represents. Now we can track the part of other current assets, that is, from undeposited funds, separately, while still including its value in the total. If we take a look at the sales account, it currently includes two subaccounts, product sales and service revenues. You can add several subaccounts at one time by copying them from Excel to your model. In Excel, create a list of account names for subaccounts you want to add. Then copy them. Let's go back to the model and right-click on Sales. From the menu, select Paste Children. Now paste the members into the dialog box. When you click Paste, those members are added as subaccounts to Sales. Each new subaccount is assigned a subaccount number. In this tutorial, you saw how to set up subaccounts in strategic modeling. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.